on releasing the Spirit with power, okay? So if you can, just stand up. All right. So just, we're going to do this. So in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the power of the Holy Spirit.
In the power of the Holy Spirit.
I speak.
Life.
Life.
When you do that, I want you to open up your, do you hear it? In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Pain, go.
Pain, go.
Be healed.
Be healed.
Here's, what you're doing is you're hitting them with the word. You know, you're releasing from here. You're not up in here. You're not trying to analyze, I wonder if this will work and all that kind of stuff. Mind, just be settled. You know, believe, right? So is that simple enough? So you don't have to wonder, oh, what did he say? Was it the Holy Spirit first? Or it's not saying the right words. And this is what you're going to do. You're going to, in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, I speak life. Pain, go. Be healed. Something simple. Tell the bad thing to go. So if they tell you, when they come up, what do you need healed? Well, I got several things. No problem. Okay? So if they've got several things, they got more than three things, sometimes my assumption at that point is that they have a spirit of infirmity. Okay? So one of the things that I'll do at that point is I'll say, fine, in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, infirmity, you go right now. Leave them. Body, be healed. All pain, go. Okay? It's very simple. You've heard how we've prayed. Then I'll tell them, do something you couldn't do. There was different ways Jesus healed, with the laying on of hands, with the word of command, and by telling people to do something that they couldn't do. Go, show yourself to the priest. Why? I still got leprosy. Just go. Okay. Hey, I'm healed. Right? Get up and walk. Well, I can't get up. I'm saying, get up and walk. Hey. You know? So what happens is this, is that as they don't have to have faith, but as they align themselves to come under the authority of your word, because you are God's representative, that they are now, it's like when Jesus was walking on the water and he says, come, right? Now Peter comes under the authority of that word, and the authority of the word has the power to fulfill it, right? And then all of a sudden now he's walking on water. So when you say, do something you couldn't do, move around, test it out. That's not telling them, hey, let's see if it worked. That's part of activating their miracle. It's almost like, you know, you got those chemicals that you break each pouch, you know. Now you got to shake it, right? All of a sudden it's glowing, all right? So that's what you're doing. You put it in them. Now, shake it up. Okay, there, it's working its way in. See? So you'll tell them, do something you couldn't do. Move your shoulder. Yeah. Yeah, and so that's a real simple thing. One of the things, too, with working with people, do you have pain when you do that? Okay, so if you move it now, you have pain? Okay. All right, in Jesus' name right now, shoulder, you be healed. In the name of Jesus, pain, go. Be whole, be healed. Now say, now, move it around. Well, it's still there. Okay, what was your pain to begin with? So, you know, on level scale of 10. Well, it's about a 7. Move it now. What's it now? Well, it's about a 5. See, if you just heard it's still there, then you might think, well, nothing's changed. And they might think, well, they're waiting for an instantaneous microwave miracle because we're Americans, you know. You press the buttons and, doggone it, it's still not working, you know. But they need to see, oh, it's warmer now. You know, I just need to put it back in for 30 more seconds, right? So that can be helpful when there's pain involved. Find out where it starts and say, okay, move it now. Hey, that's better. But just don't take no for an answer. Say, okay, great. Well, let's hit it again. In Jesus' name, put more life. In Jesus' name, I release life. Life. Be whole, be healed. Good. Now, move it down. Good. And we'll usually hit this 2, 3, 4 times. And because there's a team of people around, you know, then if they're still not experiencing complete breakthrough, get a partner. Hey, come on over. You know, want you to hit them. See, the devil doesn't know how to stand up against the body of Christ moving in power. What he's used to is he's been trained oftentimes to that if I can throw enough of a tantrum and resist long enough, eventually they'll get discouraged and leave me alone. And so you bring another fresh soldier in, you got the surge forces that you bring in, you know, all of a sudden, holy smokes, they're not discouraged at all. You know, boom, 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 boom. Okay, you're coming along. Boom, 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 boom. It's like tag team versus a solo match. You know, you're not going to win that match. So that's part of the advantage of having a life team, a life group, a church, a fellowship of believers, a company, a special ops troop.
That's why we plug you into our cell phone number or something. Hey, if you're having a bad one, we could be driving down the highway. We've done this hundreds of times. Hey, will you agree right now? Here, I got it to move, but I need some backup. It's like calling the hotline. Hey, blast this again. And the enemy, especially if you're out of state, it's kind of like you're in war. We were over in overseas in war, and our smart bombs were hitting them, and they didn't know where they're coming from. That really just breaks them. Bam! Like, where's that one coming from? They're out of here.
So I want everybody to get a partner right now. We're gonna do this. Now you did it kind of in the air. Let's just do it a little bit live, okay? Just grab somebody close to you. All right, Dave. All right, the one who's the tallest. The one who's the tallest gets to be the minister first, okay? All right. So Dave's gonna be the one ministering. If you're receiving ministry, what I want you to do is you'll tell them, just put your hands out and have them put them palms down, face out like that, okay? And Dave's gonna show you how you grab their hands, all right?
We grab from the side. The reason being, if he clamps up and I'm like this, and he falls over, I end up on top of him, and it's really embarrassing. So we don't want you to get in trouble, especially if it's a man or a woman. It really doesn't look good. We've had people do that. So if you do it sideways, even if he clamps up, I can get out.
Quick release.
And if there's no catcher, it stops the fainting goat.
Yeah, it keeps people from faking falling out.
And if you fall out under the power of God,
God's got your back, right? But you fake it, then, you know, who knows what's going to happen. I didn't push you over.
Right.
I'm going to try to hold you up, but I'm not going to fall on you. So
what I got a great video of me getting flipped over by this big 350-pound woman that she locked her knees and went just like this, and I didn't want her to hit the back of her head with 350 pounds, so I was going to ease her down, and all of a sudden I got way too much momentum, and she launched me into the first row.
I'm sorry.
I know that feeling.
Yeah. We got one with Patty hitting the ground and her shoes flying against the wall. That's why we do what we do. We found out how not to do it. So what I do, and you get your own personality. This is just basic. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I speak life. Spirit of infirmity, you. And I'm gonna tense my belly, and I, just for starters, it isn't a volume, but you can't pray out of your spirit if you get loud. Kind of like martial arts people, hi-ya, except they did it illegally. Now you're going to use it scripturally. So I'll go, life, right now, in Jesus' name. And if I'm holding your hand, I can't push you over. So we eliminate getting accused of, oh, they pushed me over. You can't push somebody over. I mean, I maybe you could. I don't know how you do that. We don't want any fake stuff. We're trying to eliminate, the church as a whole has enough bad reputation. We're trying to eliminate as much bad reputation as we can.
You don't have to yell, but that mindset of, yeah, you know, that kind of, you know, but what you're doing is you are releasing power from you're putting the power, and that's what you're releasing. You are hitting the sickness and the works of the devil in them.
Amen.
So you are going, in the name of Jesus, you go now, or I release life. And so you don't have to be loud. I can do that very quietly in Jesus' name. Go. It's not the volume, but it can help you at first to get used to actually releasing the power of the Spirit if you don't worry about whether you're loud or not. Just focus on go. You know, you're really here. You're not up here. Okay? All right, tall ones, go ahead and do your thing. Just how you're going to do it tonight. We're not going to tell you what to say. We already told you what to say. Go ahead.
In the name of Jesus, I release right now in Jesus' name. Go.
Okay. Now switch it up. Short one, do it now.
Not necessarily a feeling, but usually there is, you'll feel a presence go. That's what we do when we go to the prison. We want them to know what they've got. Not only that, they know, hey, I've never done that. I just got born again to the Holy Ghost, now alone. I feel it. Don't go by feeling, but usually when you're ministering, you can feel power hit you.
Yeah. How many of you, as you ministered, you could sense the virtue going out from you? There was a, okay. Oh, and then how many of you, as you received ministry from your partner, you could actually feel the virtue being released to you? Yeah, that's what you want. You want to release the power, and it's perceptible. If it's not perceptible to you, it may be perceptible to them without you perceiving it. But there is, you know, Jesus said he perceived power going out for him. We don't depend on feelings. We minister by faith, but there is a perception of the power. So, yeah. Okay, you can.
I can do this without saying any words.
About 10
minutes. Yeah, release the kingdom without words. Did you feel it?
I did.
Okay, that's why you were backing
that's
up.
That's why I was backing up, because I didn't want to fall over.
I didn't want you to fall over.
But I wanted to demonstrate you don't have to. But if I got one shot at somebody, I'm gonna give them my best shot.
So tonight we'll coach the people as they come forward for ministry. Just introduce themselves, tell them very briefly in English, not Latin doctor terms, you know, what it is that you want healed. And basically we tell
one or two sentences.
Don't tell us the whole medical history. Just tell us, I need healing in my heart, my lungs, and my stomach, or whatever. You know, just. You don't have to name the conditions even. But we just want to know general what it is.
Just speak English. Don't be like, what is it? Well, my head hurts. Why didn't you say your head hurt? Not give me a, you know, they're speaking in tongues. Or I got a lung condition. They have this CP whatever. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
You need new lungs. Okay, that's easy.
Yeah. So that's how we'll minister tonight, and this will be exciting. So after you hit something once, you know, 2, 3, 4 times, have them, you know, keep having them do stuff, and then say, and then, you know, you can switch around, say, hey, you know, hey, let's have somebody else hit them, and if you run in, and that's part of your ministering under our direction, okay, and so you're not on your own, there's no pressure on you, and so we're going to make sure that people get what they receive, but we want you to know that we have every confidence that Jesus can use you and will use you tonight to heal people and to set people free. So we're looking forward to that.
We were at the homeless ministry a couple weeks ago, which there's 300 and some beds.
and a guy got shot. He still had the bullet in his leg. And we blasted him. It was me and Patty, and you know, we raised the dead, and we couldn't get it to move, So me and James, he's like me, we said, we're going to beat this thing. So we blasted him together, and he said, what, from a 10 to a 9? We blasted him and went 8. Blasted him, 7. Got him down to 1, and we couldn't get it to move. We'd spent too much time. It shouldn't take that long. I said, let's walk. And we made one lap walking him around, and he just got happy. And I said, you're a minister, aren't you? Nope. You're a minister. Now, I know enough that God is right and every man's a liar. What do you mean? I know he's right and I'm wrong. Mm-hmm. People just think I'm right all the time. No, I just learned how to listen real good. You're a minister. No, I ain't. Well, I went to Bible college and I used to be a pastor. So why didn't you just admit to it? And he got in trouble and got shot. And he was at the homeless shelter. I think he was just embarrassed. But when you get, you know, a word of knowledge is big, bold letters. I'm a minister. But he just got totally set. I bet that bullet is not there. I didn't make him take his. It was, I didn't want to see it.
Won't you guys have a seat. We'll finish up tonight, and then we'll be back here tonight for the miracle service at 7 o'clock. Steve was going to share a word real quick, and then we'll get out of here and come back tonight.
Having fun. Mm-hmm. All right, he's preaching better than you guys are amening. No, it's been good. So anyway, we are not going to do an offering for the miracle service for various reasons. One of them is because a lot of people will send money and checks, and they'll say, for my healing. They'll think that they're sowing for their healing. And that's one of the reasons why we don't do it anymore. And it's not that there's anything wrong with it per se, but it's just something that we don't want people to think. And so anyway, we're just going to do one last offer for our wonderful teachers. And one thing too, I'll just ask, the owner of this building has been really awesome to me and to us. And he had some expectations that weren't met. And I would like to ask for, if you're led, just to give a special offering for him. You can give it to me, and I promise I won't pocket it. but I know that, especially in Door County, it's a seasonal place. And I know he was probably hoping that a lot of people would come here and stay at the hotel. But since most people here are local or have houses, then and if you didn't, that's okay. We're not blaming you or anything like that. But I know when you hold a conference and give people deals and that kind of thing. But anyway, I don't want to draw out too much, but if you feel led, just maybe make a donation. I'll just say, hey, man, I know that some things have gone on that you don't understand or whatnot, but I'd just like to bless you. And something can happen, especially when there's that softening of hearts. You know, we're not doing this to, it's like a bribe, to let us come back, anything like that. If I ever come back, it doesn't bother me. Hopefully we'll do it at church. But anyway, we're going to pass the basket around for our teachers. And if you feel led, you can give it. All right, Phoebe will pass it around. And then if you feel led as you're leaving out, you can give me either write it to Steve Brandt, give a check, BRANDT, STEVE, or just cash, and then I'll pass it on to him. So anyway, you guys are awesome. Love you all. Can't wait to see what God's going to do tonight. And the rest of the summer, we are changing the world. Amen. All right. Amen. Jesus was one man, and he died. For what reason? To bring many men to glory. Amen. Okay. So you're those people. It says he suffered for the joy that was set before him.
Amen.
All right. I'm that joy, and you're that joy, and you all that joy. And so we're just going to praise Jesus.
Amen.
And live for him.
Amen.
So.
Amen.
Keep going. You're getting touch right now.
Go ahead, baby.
We just got a, you can tell you the owner here that we'll put his thing on our TV show. There's 35,000 people a quarter watching.
to help him recoup some of that. You know, this is a vacation place. Who knows how many people he can get. The town will do that. I didn't know that was part of the deal.
Well, it's not part of the deal, but.
Shouldn't be.